good once you get the stacks up, but pre-stacks, man, it is rough. Very rough. And honestly, you need to go attack speed over area damage. I have to go area damage because that's just what I have available to me. But you really need attack speed here, you need attack speed here, and you need, yeah, your attack speed here, and you need attack speed here. Because if you see, your Blood Lance is hitting way harder. Brittle Touch. It's just that this is giving me more AoE.
Brave the rifts, and you will be well rewarded.
I grow weak. with.
Thank you.
obviously. Got away. Go to town and just chill. Wait for your cooldowns to come up. Doesn't really matter if you drop your stacks, because when you go back in, you're going to have him frozen, and you'll be instantly back up to 25 stacks. But that was a much better run than my 107. I feel a lot more comfortable in the spec now. So we just go back in. We're in our perfect time for our COE cycle. Get max eyes there. When we come back, we will pop the RG. So, looks like with my sheet DPS, which is only 2.5 million in this spec, the way that I'm playing it, you know, you need two rotations on a 108 Rift Guardian. I did one shot the 107 Rift Guardian, so it looks like as you go up from 108 and higher at 2.5 million sheet DPS, you will need two rotations. If you, you know, have attack speed on the right gear, you will not need the... on PTR, which doesn't mean very much, but, you know, at least, you get familiar with the spec before, before you, you know, go live. Which is really all I wanted to do. I kind of got bored of playing Season and pushing Rathma and messing with Trags on live. It just it wasn't really for me. So again, your best roll on your gloves would be the attack speed quadfecta. Second best is going to be area damage quadfecta. You know, you really want to try to group those mobs, and you're able to do that with the shield pylon, which if you're stuck where I'm at, that's why shield for me is the best by far. Your shoulders, this will always be the best DPS roll, but the best roll overall might be getting vitality in place of the area damage. It's really up to you, you know, how you want to play it. I think area damage is really good for the spec, as long as you can group mobs up. You know, if you get those melee mobs, it helps out a lot, but you can really only get area damage on these two pieces, and your compass rose. Really not even the compass rose, because you need vitality to be attack speed on this ring, and if it was attack speed, it would then be pretty much a perfect roll. So that's pretty much the only changes. Obviously this, you would want attack speed and cooldown. You know, either you have to roll off the 10% damage or the 1000 int to get those. I couldn't do that on this one because it rolled with like life on hit or something. And again, one more thing, another tip, the best potion to use is going to be a life on hit potion. It will keep you alive when you pop all your cooldowns. It helps out a lot. As you saw on that one also, I went cannibalize, and that helps keep you alive also. As long as your health pool is around 900k, you really don't need to use satiate. You know, you have to put some paragon in health in order to get that, especially where I'm at. But if you had the 600 vit on shoulders, then you know you could come down a little bit on your vit here and put it in intelligence. But you're kind of just like trading at that point. Anyway, I wanted to make a better video than my 107 video for the Pestilence clear, for the Pestilence push build. This is what I think the push build will be going into next season. For Pestilence, Decrepify, Borrow Time, Blood Rush, Molting, because you need the corpse. Corpse Lance, Brittle Touch. Devour, Cannibalize, Simulacrum Reservoir, Simulacrum Reservoir, Land of the Dead, Frozen Lands, and then Spreading Malediction. You get a huge bonus there, you know, by having a lot of mobs cursed. There's no cap on that. Overwhelming Essence, that's 120% damage right there. Final Service, and Standalone. And again, the cube, you can't see it, but it's Raylana's Shadow Hook. The Corpse Lance shoulders, and because I'm not wearing a Krispy Kreme ring, your Krispy Kreme Krismans is in the cube. Alright, I think I pretty much covered everything, except remember we are using a Molten Wildebeest Gizzard solo for this spec, and it synergizes really well with it. So, I hope you enjoyed the 108 clear. Wasn't looking at the camera. Thank you so much for watching the video. Have a great day. So 108 and 12 with 2.5 mil sheet. You're gonna have more sheet DPS during a season, trust me. Have a good day.